Hey guys, what's up? It's TerraDog. Welcome back to GT Sport, episode 8. And this is going to be sort of like an endurance race in sport mode. We're watching my replay now so that I can actually commentate because I did not have the mic hooked up. And even if I did, I was in serious mode, so I wasn't talking. So yeah, just gonna wait for this thing to load, and here we go. So this is 10 laps on Nürburgring GP, Group 3 race cars. Start out holding pretty tight to the rear end of this Mercedes. I'm trying to figure out where I can make a move. Not really trying to make a move just yet. Just, you know, kind of biding my time and waiting to see if he makes a mistake. Trying to see, you know, get an idea of how he's going to drive. I'm kind of driving my own line here. It doesn't really match up with everyone else. I tend to go wide on the exit of that one corner because of the handling of my car being a little bit tricky. It likes to oversteer a bit on the exit. I can bring up let's go to all, and you'll see, you know, just how much I was working the throttle. It was certain corners. You see, I'm kind of stabbing at the throttle. Force the car to skid ever so slightly. Just a little bit oversteered, but very well controlled for the most part. I'll let you get this info out of the way. So as you can see, I'm thinking about making a move here. It doesn't quite work. I don't have quite enough grip. Now I'm just going to keep up with him. So he dives in a little too late. I dive in a little too early. But, well, man, that would have been the right timing, actually. But he's still in front of me. I couldn't make use of my good run out of that corner. Keeping tight on the exit there so I can get a good run through this corner. I kind of botched it up anyway. Oh, by the way, this is actually pretty cool. Being able to get in the driver's seat view right now. Like, I don't think... Yeah, it doesn't allow it on any car other than my own, but back in a GT6, you couldn't actually get into a first-person view if it were an online race, so this is quite nice. Now, if I had a shortcut button to cycle through the info settings, that would be nice, but it doesn't seem like I have one. I just have to use that menu, and that's kind of, yeah, I'm not really too thrilled with it. screwed it all up. I spun my car. Now, it's ghosting me, but you're not aware of when you're ghosted and when you're not ghosted. It doesn't actually tell you that you're ghosted. You can assume that you're ghosted, but that's probably a bad idea. So I did the sensible thing, let this guy pass before I got back on the line. And now I noticed he's not driving quite as fast. I have to go off the track there because I was having control issues. But later on, I'm able to correct that to keep the car on the track at that exit. I didn't really like that I was so frequently going off there. So let's see, do I even remember where I passed the NSX at? Yeah, what's here? No, maybe not. I nearly had a chance, but the door got slammed shut on me. There we go. Yeah, I think about going for it, but then I'm like, nope, not gonna work. But then I get a better exit. So I'm able to pass him on the outside. And he flashes lights at me, but I was checking to make sure. I checked to make sure before I moved over that I was actually all the way in front of him and not still next to him or anything. So at this point, here we go. We're on lap 4, and it's not showing how far behind I am. Live timing. So I'm like 9 seconds behind. Alright. Now just keep that in mind, okay, as you watch. And yes, there's fuel consumption, there's tire wear. As I said in the beginning, it's kind of an endurance race. But you'll see, as the tires wear a little more, I start to pick up the pace. It's not exactly intuitive, but that's just how it went. I like to say that I was getting a better feel for the car as I went, because this was my first time driving this car, which I had literally just gotten. If I move to the lead car, we can see what his lap times look like and check to see the difference between his and mine. So see there, I'm only doing two wheel on the exit. Thank you. one just barely saved that one. I'm not sure what happened. There were a couple times where I guess I was braking just a little too late, or I started to lock up a little, and I went to steer or whatever. And I had to downshift an extra gear real fast and save it. And this car is actually quite forgiving. I'm not sure if it's just normally like that or if it's the tune that I put on it. And I'm basically just tuning based on like the standard kinds of tunes that I use in GC6. So I'm running a fairly high downforce because knowing the track, I knew, you know, this is going to be not going to have room to go to a really high speed, so I adjusted the gear ratios to suit that, and I added the downforce because I knew, you know, there was going to be a lot of tight corners to deal with, and some mid-speed, and a couple mid-speed corners that would benefit from the added downforce. Let's see, if we move to the lead car, we can see my lap times from the moment, from the lap after the lap that I spun, so now, so far, are just a little faster than his laps. So I am slowly closing in, but only just a little bit. It doesn't really look like I'll be able to catch up. Just barely see it in front of me. don't know what he was doing. Looks like he lost control or something like that. Close we are now. That's 8 of 10, and I'm closing the gap, and now he has traffic to deal with. Pacing this guy. This guy might be, now either I might be able to pass, or this guy might have just been taking his time and, you know, managing his tire wear. So maybe he'll have enough grip that I won't be able to pass. But look at how I had to jump on the brake right there as he slams the door. His lines are still a little off. Compared to mine. I'm thinking, okay, well, maybe let me think about where I might make my next move. So I thought, I kind of lost it there. I got myself stuck on the outside and I couldn't get back on track. The Schumacher S. I'm right on top. I'm trying to figure out, okay, what am I going to do? What am I going to do? He jumps on the brake earlier than I expect, so I just jump past him. I'm doing what I can to control the car. And that's it. I'm in first. And we still have one lap left to go. So now, man, I was freaking nervous. Right, I'm like, oh crap, I just totally jumped past him. Entirely unplanned, but it's time to make the most of it. So at this point, I was like, okay. Instead of trying to go as fast as possible, instead of trying to widen the gap, let me just be consistent. Just drive the exact same lap that I've been trying to, that I've mostly been driving so far. And I immediately, I brake a little bit later than I expected for turn one, but I'm still able to work with it. I'm like, okay, I'm still in front. Let's not mess up again. So now he finally sees the line that I used, that I've been using for that set of corners, but it's too late. He can keep up, but it seems to be the best that he can do. see how I'm stabbing the throttle. You can hear it too. Back end's kicking out ever so slightly, but otherwise well in control. I'm gonna brake a little early coming to this chicane because I don't want to screw this up and toss the race away. But then I was gentle through the braking to make sure that I got down to the speed only when I needed to, so that I didn't quite have enough room to pass in terms of the speed difference. So celebratory high beam flashes, and that's the race. So what do you think, guys? Could this be the greatest upset in the history of sport? I don't know. I have no idea how to manage that comeback. Here's what I'm trying to do. Just so that you can see the end resulting tire wear. So it looks like he actually wore his tires out more than I did somehow. So I'm not sure what happened there. I don't know if that was, if he had more wear before or after I passed him. I didn't bother to check. But, awesome race. Alright. So I'm going to end the video here. And, see you guys next time.